a locomotive or whatever. A brand of fuel, amen, more power. Praise God. How many of you know that, amen, I don't know if you know how a train operates, but you got all of this power, all these generators, these engines, generating all this electricity. We got a machine out there in the middle that we move train cars with. And listen to it today, friend, it's a little old bitty thing. When they put it on the track and it picks up, it'll pick that car up and it'll move it. But it still will, sometimes they'll speed it. How do you get connection? We know that anything, you can build a 500 horsepower motor, but if you ain't getting connection to the asphalt, you ain't doing nothing. So you got to have connection. That thing's got to be geared right. It's got to have the right kind of tires on it. But these train wheels are steel and they slip. Amen. If you ever notice the train, amen, you'll see this little tube that comes down in front of the wheel. Amen. What that does, amen, is it discharges sand on the track. Amen. And that sand gets down in between the wheel and the track. Amen. And it gives that train traction. And it'll be able to pull off. Your wheel will sit there and spin without that traction. And you say sometimes, amen, how can sand, amen, cause it to give traction? But it creates just enough, amen, friction there that them wheels won't spin and they'll begin to, amen, stick and grab and, amen, start to move that thing forward. I want you to know something this morning, that the Spirit of God, amen, is our, amen, traction, glory to God.
Yes, amen.
I want you to know this morning, I feel His presence in this place, glory to God.
Yes.
I know this morning, amen, that if I make my mind up, I'll tell you my thought for this morning. This is what I want to extract out of these scriptures, amen, that I ain't a moving. Come on now. I'm going to tell you something today, praise God. I don't believe today that Christians ought to have to be moved. Come on now.
Amen.
I don't believe we ought to have to submit or cower down, amen, to anything or anybody. Because I believe the scriptures today, for every man, amen, for God so loved the world that He gave Him His own gave, amen, His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in Him should not perish. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen. So that lets me know this morning that it don't matter, amen, where I'm from or who I am or who I ain't. It don't matter today, amen, what I've done in my past. Amen. But I come, amen, today and I realize, amen, that Jesus Christ paid a price. Amen. An ultimate price for me and you. Amen. And He gave, amen, His life freely. Amen. They didn't take it away from Him. Amen. Jesus said to Pilate, amen, I have, amen, the power to call, amen, 12 legions of angels. Amen. Down to, amen, rescue me. You have no power left. Amen. It's been given to you from above. I want you to know something today, church. Amen. Me and you have no power. Amen. Unless, amen, it be given to us from above. That's why Jesus Christ said, amen, I must go away. Amen. That another should come. Amen. That's why He told you. Amen. To go to the upper room. Amen. And tarry. Amen. And He said that they shall be endued. Amen. With power from on high. Amen. I want to be endued with some power, glory to God. Amen. I want to pray, amen. When I pray, amen, I want my, amen, prayers, amen, to have a punch to them, praise God. Come on now. I want to get something done, praise God. Everybody, well, if it be the Lord's will, we don't know what the Lord's will is, but you ain't never read the Bible if you don't know what the Lord's will is. His will is that none should perish. But we know the Bible and the scriptures declares that they're going to be them, amen, that will not believe. They're going to be son of, amen, that's not going to want to, amen, do it the way, amen, that Christ said do it. I know we live in the United States of America and under our, amen, our nation, amen, the sovereignty of the United States. Amen, we have a democracy. Amen, but you read the Word of God. Amen, friend, it is not a democracy. Amen, because Jesus Christ said, you are my friends if you do whatsoever I command you. Amen, the Word of God is specific. Amen, that we got to believe, amen, in Jesus Christ. Amen, the price that He paid. Amen, the blood that was shed. Amen, for the remission of mine. And don't say it. Amen, glory to God. That's what I'm talking about tonight. All this morning, I ain't going to be moved. Amen. Amen. I got got my mind made up this morning. Praise God. Oh, listen. What did Paul say? He said, the devil buffeteth me. Amen. He fights against me. Praise God. Amen. Why are you praising God for the devil fighting against you? Amen. That means, amen, that I'm making a mark. Come on now. If he ain't in your face, he might be walking with you. Come on now. Amen. We want the devil. Amen. Amen. He's fighting against us. Praise God. We know. Amen. We're making a mark. Amen. We know. Praise God. Amen. That something, amen's taking place. Amen. That whenever I, amen, forget, amen, to enact what God's given me. Amen. When I act on the ministry that God has laid in my lap. Amen. I begin to see things. Amen. Take place. Glory to God, Brother Terrell. Amen. And I ain't going to be moved. Let me read these scriptures. Cast thy burden. Y'all with me?
Amen.
Cast thy burden. Psalms chapter 55, verse 22. Cast thy burden upon the Lord. Amen. Sounds almost like Matthew 11, 28. Amen. The first public invitation that Jesus Christ gave to me. And everybody there, Psalms 55 and 22. Cast thy burden upon the Lord. In Matthew 11 and 28, he said, come unto me, all ye that are heavy laden. Amen. All ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Amen. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me. Verse 29, for I'm meek and lowly in heart. Amen. He's telling us in the scriptures. Amen. That if we'll cast, come on now, cast thy burden upon, amen, the Lord. Amen. Where did he want? Amen. You to put all your problems. Amen. He wants you to put all your problems. Amen. On him. Amen. You know why? Because Bruce, he's got the power to tote him. Amen. If you'll lay him on him. Amen. And take no thought. Amen. For tomorrow, glory to God. If you'll put him in the hands of Jesus. Amen. And trust him. Amen. You won't be moved.
Amen.
You know why we get sick?
God bless.
Amen.
There's going to be a tomorrow. But that tomorrow might be eternity. I know we're not even promised the next minute, but listen. Verse 22 says, cast thy burdens upon the Lord, and he shall what?
Sustain.
He shall sustain thee. Amen. So my mindset this morning is I ain't going to be moved. Amen. I know that we fight against the evils. Amen. And the principalities of Satan. Amen. And all of these devices. Amen. The wiles. Amen. And the devil that they call them. Amen. But glory to God. Amen. The Bible tells me. Amen. That whenever I cast all my cares. Amen. Upon him. Amen. Not only is he going to bless me. Amen. But he's going to sustain me.
Yes. Amen.
Amen.
Y'all see what I'm preaching?
Amen.
Well, it's God, I see it. I got a disease. Amen. Cast all your cares upon him.
Amen.
And he'll sustain you. Amen. He'll sustain you. I've known people, amen, that's been given life, death sentences. You're going to live this long. Amen. And they live on and on and on and on and on. Amen. Come on. Kind of like Hezekiah. God said, get your house in order. Amen. He fell down on his knees. Amen. He cast all his cares upon the Lord. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. God told a man to go back and tell him 15 more years. Amen. How many of you know? Amen. When you cast all your cares upon the Lord, amen, he'll bless you. He'll sustain you. He'll meet your needs. Amen. He'll give you the grace and the ability to walk on with him. Praise God.
Amen.
Listen to this. And he shall, listen, never. Y'all know what the world says. Never say never. That's what the Bible says. He shall never suffer the righteous to be what?
Amen.
How many of us in here today is righteous?
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Amen. Amen.
That's a question. I want a response. How many of you here know whether or not you're righteous or not?
Yes.
Amen. Who can be righteous in this day? Him that doeth righteous, he is righteous, even as he is righteous. 1 John 3:7. Amen. I want you to know something today. Amen. In the Bible, amen, is for this. Amen. And we would read it. Amen. Take it into our hearts. Amen. Glory to God. Learn it. Amen. And know it. That we'll be able to stand on the rock. Amen. Jesus Christ. And not be moved.
Amen.
Y'all get what I'm preaching.
Amen.
Amen. Y'all feel the confidence that I'm talking about.
Amen.
Amen. Whenever I suffer, praise God. Amen. I can know beyond a shadow of doubt. Amen. That my God walks with me. Listen. Amen. Daniel in the lion's den. Amen. Not there yet, but on his way. Amen. They had made up a thing. Amen. Against him. Amen. A decree. And the king Darius had signed it. Amen. And it was that nobody could worship any other thing other than King Darius. I want you to know today, praise God, Daniel was in a pickle. Amen. But the Bible says, amen, like he had always done. He went up into his house on a certain hour. Amen. And he began to pray. Amen. And as he had done, amen, all the days before. Amen. He prayed just like he always had. Even though they had made a law. Amen. Saying that you can't do it. Amen. You know what he said? Amen. I'm not going to be moved. I'm going to continue on to do as I've always done. Amen. And they made an accusation against him and brought him before the king. And the king knew, glory to God, that it could not be changed. Amen. Because of the law. But I want you to know one thing. Amen. You know what he said? He said, Daniel, amen, call upon your God. Amen. The one true God. Amen. And he throwed him in the pit. Amen. And he did not sleep none that night. But he come back the next day. And he called out Daniel's name. Amen. And you know what Daniel said. Amen. Here am I. Amen. Because an angel come back. Amen. Glory to God. And shut the mouth of the lion.
Yes.
That my God, he's waiting right there for me. When I call upon his name and I say, Lord, I'm tempted above what I'm able to bear. He says, look her here. Amen, my child. I'm going to give you a way of escape. I'm going to shut the mouths of the lion.
Yeah.
I'm not going to be moved. That's kind of confidence, amen, only comes by praying and fasting. This kind of confidence only comes, amen, by knowing, amen, Jesus Christ is your personal Savior. Listen, he said he shall never suffer the righteous to be moved, but thou, O God, shalt bring them down into the pit of destruction. Who is he talking about? He's talking about them same people. Amen. And it says in Psalms chapter 1 and verse 6, amen, that they shall not stand in the congregation of the righteous. He's talking about the sinner and the ungodly. I want you to know something this morning. If scarcely the righteous be saved, where will the sinner and the ungodly appear? I can tell you where they'll appear. They'll appear in judgment just like me and you. And they'll be cast, amen, out. He'll say, praise God to them. Amen, that cannot be moved. Them that's got, amen, confidence in God. He'll say, enter into the joy of the Lord, thy good and faithful servant.
Yes.
Amen, but to that slothful and wicked servant, amen, he'll be cast into outer darkness. Amen, what did he say? Glory to God. In the parable, amen, of the wheat and the tares. He said, let them grow together. But all things coming today. I'm not going to tell you today, praise God. And that day is a day of judgment. Amen. And when that day of judgment comes, he's going to go and he's going to gather the wicked. Amen. Them that have not served God, he's going to gather. Amen. And he says they're going to be bound hand and foot and cast into outer darkness. I've come this way this morning, amen, not to try to build your, amen, your confidence on enticing words. Amen. But I want to build your confidence, amen, on the power of the Spirit of God. Amen. And if you'll stand on the rock, amen, Jesus Christ said, I am the foundation. And the Bible says this, amen, that if a man would build his house, amen, upon a solid foundation, amen, strong would be the wind. Amen. They would not be able to blow it down. Amen. But a man, a foolish man that built his house, amen, upon the sand, it says, amen, that when the winds will come, amen, in the storm, amen, that his house will be blown down, and great will be the fall of it. I've come today to tell you, friend, amen, that we can have a mindset in us today, amen, that no matter what the old deceiver, amen, sins mine in your way, amen, I can say glory to God, amen, without a shadow of a doubt. Amen, I don't know what's coming in tomorrow, amen, but I know who's sending tomorrow. I ain't gonna be moved.
Amen.
Amen. I'm gonna stand. Listen to this. But thou, O God, shall bring them down into the pit. That's why the Bible tells us, amen, not to take vengeance. Because vengeance is the Lord, belongs to the Lord. Y'all bear with me just a few more minutes. Listen, you know what I want? Let me read your scripture, I'll tell you. But thou, O God, shalt bring them down into the pit of destruction, bloody and deceived. Me shall not live out half their days. But I will trust in what?
Thee.
Praise God. What is the man saying? Amen. He's saying, praise God. Amen. People, amen, have tried to do it their own way. Amen. People that's got their own ideas about salvation. Amen. People that believe, amen, you ain't got to, amen, live a clean, pure life. Listen to me today. If you don't believe God will judge sin, amen, the whole Bible is a lie. Amen, because let me tell you something, amen, and I know today that it ain't. Amen, God to judge the sin of the world. Amen, he said so in Exodus 30. Praise God. In Exodus chapter 32, amen, verses 30, 31, and 32, amen, God said that he would judge, amen, the iniquity of his people. And I got news for you today. If I want to be able to stand in the judgment, amen, if I want to have a mindset, amen, glory to God, I'm talking about dancing, amen, in the glory of the Lord, amen, in his presence, amen, because I know, amen, on him I'm stood, amen, and I declare today, amen, that I will not be moved. Amen. Yes, I want to be moved. I want to be moved. Amen. But I'll only be moved, amen, by the stirring of the Spirit of God.
Yes, Lord.
How about that? You know what I want? I want people to come to church, amen, and they ain't got their mind on, amen, Anastasia, before they ever get here.
Come on now.
Right now.
You got people that come, but even before they ever get out of their car, they're thinking about leaving. Come on now. Praise God. High in the world. Amen. Can you ever get the victory? Amen. When all you got on your mind is something else. Amen. When you come into the place. Amen. And the Bible says everything that has breath, let them praise the Lord. Amen. When you come into the house of God, you should enter with praise and thanksgiving. Amen. Amen. You come in here, amen, with washing clothes on your mind.
Amen. Bless him, Lord.
Oh, Lord, I hope that preacher don't preach all day. I got to be home washed clothes. Amen. I hope that old preacher don't preach all day. I get home and wash the rigs. He'll be starting. Well, I got a newsflash for you. They run that rig the next night. Come on now. Amen. How do we get this what I'm talking about? Amen. This thing, listen. Amen. This is a surety, Sister Sherry. Amen. And deep down inside of me, I got it. Amen. And no matter what happens, amen, if they can throw me in the lion's den, and I know that ain't even, amen, even something we even fear today. Amen. But just say it like this. Amen. What if I made a mistake on my taxes? Come on now. Amen. And the government fires it out. I'm talking about a mistake, not cheating.
Come on.
Maybe your tax preparer put a zero there when it should have been free. Oh, you working, amen, everything running right on time, just like, amen, the clockwork. You able to meet the bills, amen, everything, having just a little bit of money extra. Amen, everything's going good. Go to the mailbox one day, there it is. IRS. Amen, we found a mistake. You owe about $3,000 in back taxes. Come on now. How in the world am I going to make it? Amen, glory to God, I'm just making ends meet. Come on now. Amen, but you know what you do. Amen, you don't give it over to the devil. Amen, what you say. Amen, it's IRS. Amen, my father owns the cattle of 1,000 hills. Amen, glory to God. Amen, something that the enemy's trying to interject. Amen, but I will not be defined. Amen, by a $3,000 shortfall. Amen, but what will define me? Amen, it's how I overcome. Amen, by subtraction. Amen, debt. Amen, how I overcome it. Amen. Whenever I prayed, amen. And the Lord, amen. He reached down and grabbed hold of me and sustained me.
Yes.
In my hour of need.
Bless him, Lord.
Amen. You know what you're talking about, preacher? You better believe it. Me and my wife have a $28,511 doctor bill. Amen. Come on now. Oh, my insurance company said they wasn't going to pay it. She had had a heart operation done. It's been many years. Some of y'all heard me tell this story. Amen. I was at my house one day putting up fence. Amen. I had a tractor hooked to the fence and I was stretching the fence. Amen. Brother Ronnie, amen. And I was kind of praying about this thing. And I was saying, Lord, you know I ain't got the money. Amen. And it'll take us forever to pay off $28,000 doctor bill. $25 to $50 a week. Amen. Any of y'all know what I'm talking about this evening?
Amen.
This morning, any of y'all ever have to pay something $25 to $50 a week?
Yeah.
Praise God. It was out of network. Amen. She had to have it done. We had to have it done. Brother Ronnie, it didn't matter if it was in or out of network. It had to be done. Amen. But I want to tell you something today. Amen. God spoke to me and told me, amen, to sow, amen, a $500. You say God don't tell you the amount. Yes, he does. Amen. I want you to know something, God. Amen. This man had a need. Amen. He was trying to make a CD. Amen. And God said, if you will help him, amen, I'll bless you. Amen. Listen to me. I know how God works. You've come too late to tell me how God works. Amen. I want to tell you something. Amen. Me and my wife, we sat down that evening. Amen. Before when she came in, she drove, amen, out there where I was putting up the fence. Amen. She drove by out there. And me and her was just talking about the day. Hadn't said anything to her. Amen. About it. She said, you know, I was praying today about this doctor bill.
Come on.
And she said, God said if we'd sow a seed in the Brother Rick's ministry, Brother Rick Griswold, I don't mind telling you who it was. If we'll sow a seed in there, and I was thinking to myself, oh God, how good you are.
Amen. To let me know, amen, it wasn't just me, amen, but not only to me, you spoke to my wife. How many of you know that, amen, that God said, amen, that a man shall leave his mother and father and cleave unto a woman, amen, and they shall become one. I want you to know something, amen, when you get unity, amen, in your house, amen, when you put God before everything else, amen, I put God before my wife, I put God before my children, amen, but then my wife, amen, comes next, amen, and then the children, amen, not the children before the spouse, amen, but the spouse comes before the children. That's why we got so many wrecked marriages nowadays, amen. Mama's put, amen, little Johnny ahead of her husband. That ain't the way it's supposed to be. Husband's supposed to come before little Johnny. Amen. That's Bible. Listen.
Bless him, Lord.
Amen. We got our income tax back, amen, to have benefits seen. Amen. And coming just in time. We didn't hesitate, amen. Listen, we didn't hesitate. We wrote that check. And I ain't saying this to brag on me, amen, but I'm telling you, amen, whenever it comes to serving God, I can't be moved. I know the enemy, amen, he desires to shift me as weak. I knew that when I got up this morning. I know, praise God, that he's throwing fiery darts at me. I know he desires, amen, to kill, steal, and destroy me. Amen, but when I got up this morning, amen, I said, bring it on. Amen, because I can't be moved, because I was standing. Amen, because God said, for you, who can be against you? And get free of you. I cannot be moved. Can't change my mind. Amen.
If something happened, amen, God forbid, if everybody changed their mind between now and tonight, and I come in here and they say, Brother Scott, we took a vote, we voted you out. You're no longer the pastor of this church anymore. Amen. You know what? I might not be preaching here next Sunday, but I guarantee you, I'll be preaching somewhere.
Amen.
Amen.
You know why? Because I cannot be moved.
Listen,
the church didn't call me. Amen. The church can't fire me. Amen. I heard one preacher say, hey, my church can fire me.
Yeah, y'all can fire me, praise God, but amen, you can't fire me for being a man of God.
Amen.
What am I standing on? Amen. Praise God. We bought $111 worth of cakes that night. Amen. And we give them everyone back to be sold. Amen. We sold $611 into that man's ministry that night. Amen. A week later, I got a letter. Amen. From the Baptist Hospital. Amen. Saying that every bit of that $28,000, only thing I owe was $611. Amen. That $28,000 had been done away with. Amen. You can't tell me. Amen. And I can't have the confidence. Amen. To know. Amen. And I can declare unto the devil, I cannot be moved. Amen. The only way I can be moved, amen, is if I turn around and step off. Amen. But I got news for you today. There can't nothing move me that I don't allow. Amen. To move me.
God bless.
Amen. I know some of you in here is waiting on your husband to come to church with you. Just carry on. He'll come. I promise you, I talked with a woman here one Sunday morning. She told me I ain't gonna call her name. She said it had been 21 years since her husband had been to church with her. She wanted us to pray. 21 years. He hadn't come. I said, he'll come. Sunday in, Sunday out, she'd come, get out of the car. He wouldn't be with her. She'd come in, I said, look here. He's coming. I'm leaving. Next Sunday, no. Wouldn't be with her next Sunday. Next Sunday. You know that old devil was saying, you know what he said? Just pass it. You're not told her that. You're not told her that. See, her husband ain't coming with her, but you know what? Amen. I was standing out there and I want to tell you something. Amen. That link was pulled in there and I want you to know something. Old Norris went over. And there he did. He stepped out. Come on now. I want to tell you. Amen. When God says it, amen, free, and I want you to know something. Amen. You can stand on it because it cannot be moved. Amen. And I want you to know today. Amen. You can have that same. Amen. Confidence that I'm talking about this morning. If you will trust. Amen. Because he sent his son into this world. I sent him to the world. But through him that the world might be saved. I'm saved, sanctified. Amen. The Holy Ghost.
sometimes you gotta fight for it. When you marry, let me tell you something. Man and woman, two different creatures. God created them both individually. And God made a covenant with the man and the woman that if they would enter into holy matrimony, understand what I'm saying? Holy matrimony. That covenant they made to each other and God. When you say, do you promise to love and cherish her, be true to her all the days of your life? And you say, I do, you make it a pledge to Erica and to God, saying, God, I pledge you to this woman that I'll be true to her. And vice versa, when she pledges, amen, to be true to thee, loving and cherishing in sickness and in health, amen, every day, praise God, she says that I'll do that, amen, she's making a pledge to him that I'll do that, and to God, saying that I, before you, God, do declare that I'll be to this man what I just said. But you know what? Life comes into action after you get through with the wedding and all the stuff that goes along with the wedding, all the happiness, all that good thing. Life comes in about a week later. Maybe about 2 weeks later. Life. You get back off the honeymoon and all that. You sit down for your first night's supper, amen, and the chicken ain't done.
There ain't no reason to turn around and go back. Amen. When I stand on the love and the mercy, amen, of God through His Son Jesus Christ, there ain't no other way. Amen. I'm telling you, Derek, I can't be moved this morning. Does anybody need prayer?